It is important to acknowledge that the current minimum wage in Pennsylvania is $7.25 per hour, which is also the federal minimum wage. This rate has remained unchanged since 2009. Now, we've talked and talked and talked about having hearings and about data and about studies. We had since 2009 to figure that out. The last 12 years, we've seen zero movement on this issue. But today, folks are outraged and they have, 24-hour notice. No, you had notice since 2009 to do something. You did nothing. Meaning that there is no increase in over 14 years. And during this time, the cost of living has continued to rise and making it increasingly difficult for low-wage workers to make ends meet. As a result, many individuals and their families struggle to afford basic necessities such as housing, healthcare, and education. Where was this outrage during COVID? Where was this outrage during 2018 when we had an economic collapse, but those frontline workers were still in their workplace, still making the same exact pay? Where was the leadership during those times? Absent. Raising the minimum wage is a critical step forward addressing what we talk about is this income inequality and this gap. It ensures that the lowest paid workers receive a pathway, and I mean a pathway because it's not a livable wage in which we're proposing. It is a compromise in which we have made with the Republican Senate. This is a companion bill. I want to make that clear. This is a compromise. If it was up to Democrats, we would do it for real, and we would have all of the bells and whistles that folks deserve because that's what we believe in, people. Make that very clear. It is also worth noting that Pennsylvania legislators have the power to determine the minimum wage. As public servants who earn $46.15 an hour, not including our per diem or gas reimbursements. I do not want to hear no outrage in this room about no $11, $13, or $15 minimum wage. It is absurd to even talk about those things. It is essential for us to prioritize the well-being of our constituents. And as you out tonight, receiving that lobbyist pay for dinner, remember, the folks who serve you make $7.25 if they're lucky, because most of them make $2.83. So if you want to do something tonight, how about you tip them a real wage if you believe so much in it? All these folks, I didn't sign the front of paychecks. Won't you sign one tonight for one of those workers? Comparing the lack of minimum wage increases to the salary or cost of living adjustment of our COLA, state legislators who receive one every year, we can't afford a COLA increase, give yours back. This salary is considerably higher than the poverty line. Let's be clear. Let me go back. I'm getting a little ahead of myself, getting a little excited. According to the data of the National Conference of State Legislatures, as of 2021, Pennsylvania legislators receive a base salary of $88,610 per year. This salary is considerably higher than the federal poverty line for a family of four, which is currently $26,000. As my previous colleague mentioned, minimum wage is $15,000. So therefore, they can't sustain a family. Additionally, Pennsylvania legislators receive a regular COLA increases to account for the inflation and rising costs to ensuring that their income keeps pace with the economic landscape. So let's say that again. We keep pace while we leave everyone in the dust. It's high time for us to pay. And I can go on and on, but I think we get the point. We have to humanize this debate. We have to stop talking from a figurative standpoint. These are people. We know their names. We go to these restaurants and bars on a nightly basis and depend on them to be there to serve us. But they're not good enough to receive $11 in the first year, $13 in the second year, $15 with a COLA and 26. Are we kidding ourselves? We need to look in the mirror and get serious. But this is why the grown-ups now have the chairmanship, because we are going to do something about it. And I want to thank a few folks who have actually worked on this issue over the years. Ronnie Green has been a lifelong union member, and this is an issue that she cares deeply about. And I can tell you from her own personal experiences, she does not love this bill. She may actually hate this bill, but she realizes
But she realizes something has to change. We have to move the needle. We can no longer sit idle and wait, as we have all heard, for another study, for another hearing, for another something that never came. You had 12 years to do something and did nothing. Patty Kemp, another tireless advocate since she's been here, been fighting on this issue. Representative Kinsey, Representative Rabb, our Senator Tina Tartaglione, our Senator Art Haywood. These are some of the members who have been waiting and waiting and waiting and waiting. I am so grateful that we had some Republicans in our Senate body who decided to put forth a bill that Democrats could get around. And it wasn't easy to get to this point. So I strongly urge a yes vote and show the people that you're going to see tonight that you care.